Brendan, you're back on the couch. Like, can I just say, unbelievable, you made it to the semi-finals. Yeah. You made it to the semi-finals! And you know, and you were worried you were gonna come back the next week, so you've done so well.
Yeah, I nearly came back the next week when I was in the bottom two. So
well, yeah, we'll talk about that, we'll talk about that. Let's just remind ourselves of your performance on Saturday night. Those high notes, do you clench your bum as well, like Scarlett does?
Yeah, pretty much, yeah. So it's the only way to get them out.
you were unbelievable, and I feel like that was actually your best performance, which is a good thing, right, to like leave the competition on a high.
Yeah, it was. I didn't really know what to think. You know, obviously I kicked off the show, so like I just in the middle of the performance, my mouth was all dry, and I was like, oh God, this isn't happening. But I got through in the end. I was delighted with the, I got a standing ovation as well from the judges.
Yeah.
And it couldn't have gone any better now, but unfortunately just didn't get to the final. But no, look, I'm delighted. I made it to week six.
Yeah, yeah.
Couldn't ask for a better result.
And actually, Robbie said that you dominated the stage. Did you feel like that when you were performing? Did you feel like, oh, this is my best performance so far?
Yeah, vocally I thought it was my best. Like, and I think as the weeks went on, I felt like people were getting to know me a bit better after each performance. Like, and I think, yeah, the momentum kind of
built up.
Yeah, built its way up. So, yeah, it's a lot of it's a lot to take in, a lot to think about, because, you know, you just have to realise, like, anyone would give their left arm to be in my position.
Yeah.
So, you know, I was very grateful for the way things turned out.
And you left the competition with Danny Tetley.
I did.
Who I think has been drinking too hard, and that's why he's not here. That's
absolutely
just my opinion.
Yeah. He's in bed, hungover.
Yeah, hungover bits. And then, obviously, poor Acacia and Aaliyah have to go back to school.
Yeah.
So that's a bit of a slap in the face. At least, you know, you're here.
Yeah, exactly.
Now, Louis was your judge. I heard that he was, like, at the house the most, and he was the most involved. Like, how was it having Louis as a judge?
It was amazing. I mean, like, it was just, he was literally in the house every day of the week, and he'd spend like 4 hours with each of us, and it was just and don't get me wrong, the other mentors did that too, like, you know, they tried to spend as much time with all their acts, but Louis was just like, even took me to the pub one night and just had a chat, and
really,
yeah, just were talking about his days. And
how does that work though, like, do people see spot you?
It was quite enough pubs, so I didn't say. It was like a real old man's pub, so
right,
it was all good. Yeah, but no, it was amazing getting to know him a bit better as well. And you know, that one of the nicest things he said to me as well after I left the competition, he goes, I'm a friend for life now. You know, it's someone to lean for advice or whatever.
Yeah. I'm visiting LA when you go over there as well, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
You know, and the house this year, I believe, was like very, it was, you were all so close in the house.
Mm.
So who are you going to miss the most? Like, who was your room buddy?
Anthony was my room buddy.
Oh,
he was 100 miles an hour.
Yeah,
Dalton was as well. I think Dalton just got a bit, as soon as everyone kind of moved, the choir were gone and the lads, you know, we just kind of decided to spread out. Me and Anthony actually just shared the same bunk bed for 6 weeks.
Oh God, right.
So yeah,
now you'll sleep better.
We bunk beds, yeah.
Were you top or
bottom?
Bottom.
Yeah.
Oh no.
You could blame him. You could say, I have had no sleep for 6 weeks. This is why I'm out.
No sleep, yeah. Well, I met
you. And you do have quite the female fan base.
I do.
Did you get to like meet everybody? Because you have a huge fan base from, you know, from being on the show for like 6 weeks. Were they there every week when you kind of came out?
Yeah, it was crazy. Like, I tried my best to respond to everyone by like on direct message on Twitter, and like it was just
anyone slid into your DMs?
A few people, yeah. Absolutely.
But any blue ticks?
Blue ticks?
Like, you know, some famous people. Now this isn't actually all new for you, X Factor, because X Factor is, but you did Eurovision.
Yeah, I did Eurovision.
You did Eurovision, and Louis.
Yeah.
Louis Walsh was your manager.
Louis was my manager, yeah, for two years.
So did he know you were going on X Factor?
No, he had no clue. Like, it was basically, long story short, I was 16 when I left school, and Louis was holding auditions for his new boy band.
Yeah.
So I went for that, and 6 months later I got in, and we signed a record deal, and we had a bit of success in Ireland, and just things didn't go to plan.
Yeah.
And then we got dropped then, and then Louis had to send an Irish entrant to Eurovision. So he rang me up and offered me it, and I said, yeah, absolutely. So But yeah, we just went our separate ways after that and haven't been in touch with him since. But
wait for this, because he's going to call you now, isn't he? You're going to get back to Ireland.
Yeah, I'm probably going to get a call
He's sliding into your DMs, Louis.
Absolutely.
Well, listen, you were unbelievable on The X Factor. What is the plan now? Because you did say on Instagram, you said, I'll be back. Mm-hmm. So what are you going to do? You're going to go back to Ireland?
Yeah, I might go back to Ireland for 2 days before the final and, you know, get my head down. I suppose I'll... My plan is to get a plan, so I need to. I'll look at my options. I'll enjoy the Christmas, and hopefully it'll open a few doors.
Yeah, it will. Well, this is not the end. Well done again to get to the semi-final. Sophie, it is a pleasure to have you, the Queen of Sass.
Thank you.
You look, you smell amazing as well, which people can't smell you, but you smell very, you smell expensive. Now you
that's the scent I got for.
Now you had a Made in Chelsea break, and then I love it because you came back to stir up a bit of, you know, drama.
Yeah.
Now you were closest to Mark Francis and Victoria was your side woman. Oh, why are they not anymore?
So certain friendships are just for certain parts of your life, and then you just evolve. Other people stall.
Yeah.
I evolved.
Ah, okay. Can we talk about your love life? Because you and Fred seem to be close. Like, are you and Fred a thing?
No, we're really good friends.
Okay, so are you in love with anybody at the moment?
No, or? I'm single and I hate it.
Really? Well, how have you not met anyone?
We're good.
Well, this could be something. First speed date right here. but hang on. Would you date outside of the Made in Chelsea circle?
I only date outside of.
Oh, okay. Well, this is good for you. This is good.
What do I look for in a guy? A strong character. Loyalty and a strong stamina.
And a good voice.
Good voice.
Good voice.
Really, really close.
Someone who's got to the semi-finals on X Factor, maybe.